Hi, I'm Zoe and this is Cabin Fever Science! Today, we are gonna make a telephone! Did you like how I did this?
Yes.
Like a telephone, like I'm on the a phone call. I definitely want those marshmallows and that frosting. Oh yeah, and I also want those s'mores on top. So good. Thank you, bye! It's not that kind of phone, it's a tin can phone. In this experiment, we're gonna talk into one can. The vibrations are gonna travel through the string and into the other can. First, we need to understand how sound works. Sounds are vibrations created by our vocal cords. Your vocal cords flap around really fast and they vibrate the air, and those vibrations travel to someone else's ears. And those vibrations travel to someone else's ears. Or my dad's microphone. It's a little bit more complex than that, but that's a basic idea. There are a lot of sharp and heavy things in this experiment, so make sure you have a grown-up around to help. Here is what you need. Two empty bean cans, whatever thingies. Ew, did you clean these things anyway? Some string, a small nail, a hammer, scissors! Ask your parents to take the hammer and the nail and poke a small hole in the bottom of each can. Now take a long piece of string and cut it with the scissors. Snip! Your parents should probably do that too, unless you know scissor safety. Put the string through the hole and tie a huge knot on the other side. Then do the same thing with the other can. Make sure someone's on one side of the room and the other side of the room. Hold the string tight and not touching anything so that the vibrations can move through it. While one person talks, the other person has to have the can in their ear. Can you hear me?
Yeah, I can hear you. Can you hear me?
Wow, it actually worked. I'm Zoe and this is Cabin Fever Science. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to like and subscribe.